Good morning, students. So last class we are discussing about the chapter chemical effects of electric current. So in that last class we discussed about the detectors. The bulb is a detector. I have told you that bulb, electric appliances, those are used as a detectors. LED also is used as a detector. That we have discussed in the last class. And the flow of electricity in the liquid solutions, that also we have discussed in the last class. So now in this class we are going to discuss about the chemical effects of electric current. So what do you mean by chemical effect of electric current? That we are going to discuss here. So first thing, definition of chemical effect of electric current. So definition is the phenomena of causing chemical changes by passing electricity through a conducting solution is called chemical effect of electric current. So here the phenomena of changing the chemical changes when we pass the electricity through a solution, that we call it as a chemical effect of electric current. So in that chemical effect of electric current, it involves the transformation of electrical energy into chemical energy. So the chemical effect of electric current involves the transformation from electrical energy to the chemical energy, right? So here what we are doing here, we are applying electricity, electrical energy to the solution, that is conducting solution. Then there is a changes in the chemical, that we call it as a chemical effect of electric current. So by the help of two processes we are going to understand the concept of the chemical effect of electric current. So what are those two processes? So first thing is electrolysis and second thing is electroplating. So these are the two processes. By with the help of these two processes we are going to understand the concept of chemical effect of electric current, right? So initially we defined that what is chemical effect of electric current, that definition we have discussed here. Now after that, with the help of two processes we are going to understand the concept of electric current. Those are electrolysis and electroplating. So first thing, electrolysis. So what do you mean by electrolysis? So electrolysis means breaking up of, electrolysis means breaking, it is breaking, the substance is growing, breaking by the help of electricity. So by the action of electricity, the substance is breaking, that we call it as electrolysis. So here the definition, the process of decomposition of an electrolyte on passing electricity is called electrolysis. So first thing, in my first class I have defined about the, defined the term electrolyte. What do you mean by electrolyte? So here the process of decomposition, it means splitting of electrolyte on passing electricity is called electrolysis. So here first thing, electrolysis of water we are going to study here. This is an activity, it is there in your textbook, right? So here to do this activity we require, so see here diagram, to do this electrolysis of water, here we require beaker, right? Two glass tube, that is test tube, battery, plug key and a thick copper wire, right? The corrections are made as shown in the arrangement, right? So first what we require to do this activity, beaker, right, and acidulated water solution. It means the solution, if this water solution is acidulated, then only the current will pass through that. If the water is pure, what if water is pure, then there is no conduction of electricity. That's why here we are using acidulated water to do this electrolysis of water. So here water, we are using two test tube A and test tube B, right? So to these test tube, we are connecting with the help of electrodes to a battery. Here the connection as shown here. So first, after that what we have to do, fill the two test tube with acidulated water. So in these two test tube we are going to fill the water, that is acidulated water, and we are placing over the electrodes. So after that, filling the water, place them over the open ends of the two wires of the beaker. So these are the two open ends of the wire. So on that wire we are placing the filled acidulated test tube, right? And the other end of the wire is connected to the battery. So the other end of the wire is connected to the battery. So one end is connected to the positive terminal and the other end is connected to the negative terminal with the help of plug key, right? So after connecting, what happens when the battery is connected? Here the flow of current will take place. Then after that, when current flows, then the bubbles of gases. Then the bubbles of gases are evolving at the ends of the wire. So when the current is passing through this wire, then what happens? These electrodes creates bubbles. So these are passing both the electrodes, right? The gases are liberated or collected in the two test tubes. So whatever may be the gases here liberated, those are collected in these two test tubes, that is test tube A and test tube B. So by the action of downward transfer displacement of water, so by the action of downward displacement of water, so we are lifting the test tube, filling test tube downward. So by the action of downward displacement of water, the gas is accumulated in the two test tube. So after some time, note down the volumes of the two gases. So after this some time, you note down the volume of the gases that present in the two test tube. Okay. Next thing, after gas collected in the test tube, so the gas collected at the cathode, that is in the test tube A. So here, the gas collected at the cathode, that is test tube A, is double the volume at the anode, that is in test tube B. So see here less amount of water is there, that is acidulated water. Here more amount of water is there. So here double of, here compared to here the double of the size will be there. That means here double gas is collected compared to this test tube A, right? So here that is the volume of the two gases collected are in the ratio 2:1. So by seeing the diagram, so you will come to know by the space between the test tube A and B, the air gap between the gas filled between the test tube A and B, you can tell that the volume of the two gases are collected in the test tube are in the ratio 2:1. So after that, after the test tube are filled with the respective gases, so what gases we don't know. So when the gas is filled with the respective gases, remove them. So remove the test tube and top the test tube. It means with the help of cap, then with the help of cup, you close that. And after that, bring the lighted matchstick near to the mouth of the test tube A. So bring a lighted matchstick near to the test tube of the mouth A and remove the cup. So then remove the cup. Then what happens? The gas burns the gas burns with a popping sound. It means it sounds, the gas that is filled in the test tube A, it sounds while burning. So this shows that the gas collected at the cathode is hydrogen. So here in the test tube A, the gas collected at the cathode end is hydrogen by doing this activity, by bringing the lighted matchstick near to the mouth of the test tube A. So similarly, same, conduct the similar test with test tube B. So with this test tube B also, conduct the same test, that is bring the lighted matchstick near to the mouth of the test tube B. Then what happens? The gas start burning violently. So when you bring to the near to the mouth of the test tube B, then what happens? The gas start burning violently. So here by making popping sound, here what happens? It burns violently. So this shows that the gas collected at the anode is oxygen. So the gas collected at the anode is oxygen by doing this, by bringing the lighted matchstick near to the test tube B, right? So here the volume of hydrogen and oxygen gases are in the ratio of 2:1. So by this activity, we come to know that here the volume of hydrogen and oxygen gases are in the ratio 2:1. Therefore, it is concluded that water is made up of oxygen and hydrogen. Hydrogen and oxygen. So water contains hydrogen and oxygen. The combined in the ratio of 2:1. So both are in the ratio of 2:1. That is hydrogen is 2, oxygen is 1. So electrolysis of hydrogen by electrolysis of water by reaction. So we know that water now by here only by doing this activity, water that is assimilated water, when we pass electricity, what happens? It splits into hydrogen gas and oxygen gas in the ratio of 2:1. Right? So see here, hydrogen chemical equation is H2O. When we pass electricity to this liquid water, that is water, then what happens? Hydrogen gas is liberated and oxygen gas is liberated. So in the ratio of water, 2:1. So see here the equation is balanced or not. Say 2 into 2, 4 hydrogen, 2 into 4 hydrogen, 2 into here nothing is there, it will be 1, 2 into 1, 1 of 2 into 1, 2, 2 oxygen. Here nothing is, here 1, 1 into 2 oxygen. So the equation is balanced, right? So this is all about the electrolysis of water. Right. In my next class, we are going to discuss about the applications of electrolysis. I hope you understand. You understood this concept. If you want to, for further detail, see the textbook. It is there in the textbook, page number 222. Right. Thank you.